No, I'm going. Oh shit, I gotta open the camera up first, don't I? There we go.
Go ahead with that.
Bring it on. What's your dude in the USA? Let's get it on. And that way, let's get it on.
UFC?
No, I just fucking.
Okay, this is Matthew 25 and 30. And cast ye the unprofitable servant into outer darkness, there shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth.
I start from the beginning though. With the, did you read all that? Because some of it didn't get picked up on the last video.
Oh, that's where I started.
Oh, okay.
Okay, 31. When the Son of Man shall come in his glory, and all the holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory, and before him shall be gathered all nations, and he shall separate them one from another, as a shepherd divideth his sheep from the goats.
Yep.
And he shall set the sheep on his right hand, but the goats on his left. Then shall the king say unto them on his right hand, come, ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was in hunger, and ye gave me meat. That was the point I wanted, though.
Yeah, because talking about how that goes says the same thing as the wheat and tare parable, because the heathen has been scattered amongst the Israelites. And it, well, really, the Israelites have been scattered among the heathen.
Because
it seems like Israel is the only nation that don't know who the hell they are.
And when you tell them, they don't want to accept it anyway.
Hell no. They become your enemy. They'll cuss you out. Get away from that Israelite bullshit. I'm trying to hear that shit. That's like my brother always tells me. I'm not trying to hear that shit.
Yeah, you're trying to hear that shit. That's what they say. They always say shit.
Yeah, that shit.
That shit. That's literally how their spirit is telling them, man. That is, this truth is shit. Worthless shit. Because it is worthless to them. It's worthless to them. You know, they find no faith in it. Just like Esau, you know, they got the same spirit as Esau. Esau didn't have no, in his spirit, he didn't have no use for the birthright. So he sold it. He gave it away.
Oh, you should get Romans 11:33.
Romans 11:33.
To prove, yeah, this is far from worthless.
Romans 11:33. Oh, the death.
Hold on. Hey, look, you was talking about shit and a Port-a-John's.
Shit, something. And it's literally full of shit.
Yeah, porta potties.
Yeah. Romans 11:33. Oh, the depths of the riches, both of the wisdom and knowledge of the Most High, how unsearchable are his judgments and his ways past finding out. For who hath known the mind of the Lord, or who hath been his counselor?
Oh, we was talking about that earlier, how people try to figure out the mind of the Lord.
Or who hath first given to him, and it shall be recompensed unto him again. For of him, and through him, and to him are all things, to whom be glory forever. Amen.
Yeah, that's the point, though. I mean, these riches is endless, man.
That's right.
Though the depths and the riches. But this truth goes deep. People want to talk about take a trip down the rabbit hole. Shit. You know what I'm saying? We go deep. You got something? Oh, you better come on with it. I got another one for you, dealing with the riches, if you got another one.
Hold on.
Okay.
Oh, goodness. 1 Peter 1:12. Unto whom it was revealed that not unto themselves, but unto... I can't read right.
Sorry, it's Satan fucking with you.
Yeah. Unto whom it was revealed that not unto themselves, but unto us, they did minister things which are now reported unto you by them that have preached the gospel unto you with the Holy Spirit sent down from heaven, which things the angels desire to look into. Wherefore, gird up the loins of your mind. Be sober and hope to the end for the grace that is to be brought unto you at the revelation of the Yahushua the Anointed. As obedient children, not fashioning yourselves according to the former lust and your ignorance.
Yeah, former lust and ignorance. That's pan the camera. That's all these fools.
But as he which hath called you is holy, so be ye holy in all manner of conversation, because it is written, be ye holy, for I am holy. And if ye call on the Father, who without respect of persons judges according to every man's work, pass the time of your sojourn here in fear. For as much as ye know that ye were not redeemed with corruptible things as silver and gold from your vain conversations received by tradition from your fathers, but with the precious blood of the anointed, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot, who verily was foreordained before the foundations of the world, but was manifested in these last times for you. And that's not everybody, that's just elect it's referring to.
That proves that predestination.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Everything was preordained. The script was already been written. There's no free will. There's no, creating your own reality.
Yeah, that's it.
None of that bullshit.
How many times in the New Testament the Lord gave reference to the Old Testament?
Yeah, know? All the time.
Oh, yeah. You know?
People always say you're in control of your own future.
Your own destiny. You make your
you
own
ain't in control destiny. Of a goddamn thing.
Not a nada. Shit. Seeing ye have purified your souls in obeying the truth through the Spirit unto unfeigned love of the brethren, see that ye love one another with a pure heart fervently.
Huh.
Being born again.
We're loving not by word but in deed.
Indeed, that's right.
Love you, bro.
I even hate hearing that, don't you?
That makes you want to fight.
Yeah, it don't even sound right, man. Motherfucker, man.
I love you.
Love you, man. They never did nothing.
That's your boy, Peraza.
Oh, my God.
I love y'all, man.
Love you, man.
I love y'all.
I despise the sight of him, man.
That's what I'm going to say when I see y'all. I love you, brothers. I'm going to get home and get on Twitter and be like, I love you all.
I love you all. Yeah.
That'd be my tweet.
I love you all.
I bet I get retweeted to like.
Oh, boy.
That'd be the biggest tweet I ever tweeted.
Yeah, I love you all.
Nobody will retweet it. My favorite.
Oh, they go favorite.
Your favorite. I love you all.
Yeah, Twitter's garbage anyway. I barely use it. Huh?
I heard they was thinking about changing it.
There's a limit to what?
You can't post like a big ass thing.
But
mm-hmm.
Well, it's a text though. It's designed for texts. Because you can only fit so many words in a text message.
Yeah, I heard they was changing that though.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I kind of like the shortness to it. That's just, after
you
a while.
Tweet longer where you can use the app to extend your tweet and then it just sends it to
them. Yeah, it's hard to get in battles with people on there. They talking that Gamma Famish Lama. Worshipping Apollo and Athena and all that bullshit.
Yeah, right. They don't have their gods.
I bet them bitches don't even know the Greek alphabet. Okay, talking about Alpha,
Satan
Gamma.
When the destruction come.
Remember, I can
call on gods when the destruction come.
The only Greek they know is some yogurt.
Right. Greek yogurt.
It's like, motherfucker, I can read Greek.
Fake Greek yogurt, though. Fake Greek yogurt.
Remember, they part of the, what's the one on the Revenge of the Nerds? The Lambda, Lambda, Lambda. You don't remember the Lambda, Lambda, Lambda?
I forgot about
that. That was that shit.
That was some popular shit, too.
Yeah, man. Three L's.
Lambda, Lambda, Lambda. Okay.
Me, when I got asked Christmas.
Turn your head like it's thick chips.
All right, right here. This is Baruch. 4:2. Turn thee, O Jacob, and take hold of it. Walk in the presence of the light thereof, that thou mayest be illuminated. Give not thine honor to another. Know the things that are profitable unto thee to a strange nation.
There goes that same topic we keep hitting on about the strange nations, these heathens. Don't be following after these strangers, these heathens. Don't follow their customs. Hey, read that again, man.
This is Baruch 4:3. Give not thine honor to another, nor the things that are profitable unto thee to a strange nation.
Now keep going.
That is bad right here. Let's get to 27. This is bad right here. All
right.
It says, be of good comfort, O my children, and cry unto God, for ye shall be remembered of him.
Oh, don't worry. Just read it.
Oh,
you good.
That brought these things.
Start over.
Be of good comfort, O my children, and cry unto God, for ye shall be remembered of him that brought these things upon you. For as it were, was your mind. Sorry, it's 30. Sorry. Take. Shit. What the fuck is that?
Take your time.
I thought it was 27.
Yeah, it all sounds good to me. You can read that whole book. It's going to sound like fire.
It's 25, my bad. My children, suffer patiently the wrath that is come upon you from God. For thine enemy has persecuted thee, but surely thou shalt see his destruction.
Right.
Shall tread upon his neck.
Yeah, that's a good scripture right there. Read that one again. Read in verse number and read that one again.
Luke 4:25. My children, suffer patiently the wrath that has come upon you from God. For thine enemy hath persecuted thee, but surely thou shalt see his destruction, and thou shalt tread upon his neck.
Tread upon his. And that reminds me, what's that one scripture we bring out a lot that says, it's a pleasure for you to see your enemy fall or something? It's in the Psalms, I think. We read it all the time. That's in the wash the feet in the blood of the wicked. I can find it. Here, hold this real quick. Now you good. Here.
We read this like last week. I think it's like Psalms 50 or something like that.
I don't know why I was thinking of Job though.
We just read it. See, that's why I'm saying I bring scriptures out and forget where it's at the next week. I think it's Psalms 52 maybe. Or 50? It's 50. Is it 50? Yeah, it's 50 something. That's not good. I think it's 52. Oh, here goes one of them times again. We gotta start talking.
It's not 50.
It's. I think it is 50, but it fits so long.
It's like a 3.
Yeah, try to find that. Hey, I'll take the camera back. You try to find that while I hold this. You get that, we bring something else out. It's in 50, one of them. It's in 50 something. It's after he says, watch. It says that seeing your enemy fall is a. It's not 58, is it?
Yeah, wash feet and blood.
That's in 58?
Yeah.
That's, I'm all messed up. We just brought that out, I think, last week. I knew it was 50-something.
Psalms 58:10. The righteous shall rejoice when he seeth the vengeance. He shall wash his feet in the blood of the wicked.
Keep going.
That man shall say, verily there is a reward for the righteous. Verily he is a God that judges the earth.
Hold on a second. Let these assholes leave. Goddamn Coda bus coming through. All these heathens. Huh? Oh, it's a Nintendo controller. That's pretty sweet. Hey, you guys, give it. The old Nintendo controller is like the best controller. It's hard to beat Mike Tyson without the original controller. Try to do it with a different controller. You'd be all fucked up. You gotta have the original pad. Yeah. There's too many buttons. It's like, nah. Now hold up. Take your ass on down the street. Loud ass Coda bus. Sound like about a transform and shit. And that'd be a fucking hell of a transformer, a Coda bus. You know, he's part of Decepticons. But actually, I like Decepticons better than the Autobots. The Autobots are like Uncle Tom's.
Yep, sure is.
You know what I'm saying? They work with the government and everything.
Trying to kick his ass out.
Yeah, because the Decepticons is trying to help their own people. It's like,
yes,
Hey, bring that scripture out. Let's get that.
Psalms 58:10. The righteous shall rejoice when he seeth the vengeance. He shall wash his feet in the blood of the wicked.
That's what we're going to do. Keep going.
So that a man shall say, verily, there is a reward for the righteous. Verily, he is a God that judgeth in the earth.
So, yeah, there's a reward. Yeah, so that's what we're saying. That there's a reward for the righteous. Is washing your feet in the blood of the wicked, that's a reward.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. That's one of them times you ain't going to want to wash, man. You don't want that blood to be around. Really.
It's like, yeah, because when you go into battle, just think back in the old days when they used to go to battle with axes and swords. Mm. And you got to walk all the way home. You ain't taking a shower right away after the battle. You covered in blood for a minute. You know what I mean?
That's right.
You probably got blood going all up in your eyes and all over your face. It's squirting up in your mouth. And if you get, you just drenched in blood. That's some gruesome shit, man. Washing your feet in the blood of the wicked. That's gruesome. That's what you call a bloodbath, because you literally get bathed in blood.
Yeah. We're going to go to the campfire. We ain't going to go wash and shower and go to the fire. We're going to go to the fire and gather all of us and just talk about it.
And that fire be feeling good, too.
Yep.
You feel that warmth.
You run that fire.
I love the feel of a fire.
Yeah, it's going to be beautiful, man. This time's going to be beautiful. That reward.
Yeah, that reward is something to look forward to.
For real. I'm going to read Isaiah 62 and... start at 10, 6. I have set watchmen upon the walls of Jerusalem, which shall never hold their peace, day nor night.
That's us.
Ye that make mention of the Lord, keep not silent, and give him no rest till he establish, until he make Jerusalem a praise in the earth. The Lord has sworn by his right hand.
Well, people be begging us to shut the hell up too,
right,
don't they?
Right, right.
They said, but read that part again. Because people, they be begging us to shut the hell. People begged us to leave. They be like, why are y'all still out here? How come y'all won't shut the hell up?
Yeah. Ye that make mention of the Lord, keep not silence, and give him no rest.
Give him no rest.
Till he establish, until he make Jerusalem a praise in the earth.
Have he done that yet?
Not yet.
Not yet.
The Lord has sworn by his right hand and by his arm of his strength. Surely I will no more give thy corn to be meat for thy enemies, and the sons of the strangers shall not drink thy wine, for the which thou hast labored.
There goes it. Hey, that word stranger keep popping up tonight, don't it?
Popping up, yep. But they that have gathered it shall eat it, and praise the Lord, and they that have brought it together shall drink it, in the courts of my holiness. Go through the gates. Prepare ye the way of the people. Cast up the highway. Gather out the stones. Lift up a standard for the people. Behold, the Lord hath proclaimed unto the end of the world. Say ye to the daughter of Zion, behold, thy salvation cometh. Behold, his reward is with him, and his work before him. And they shall call them the holy people, the redeemed of the Lord, and thou shalt be called sought out, a city not forsaken. That was it on that.
Yep.
Oh, I keep on reading though.
Oh, yeah, it's all fire. I mean, yeah. I like hearing the word.
Isaiah 63. Who is this that cometh from Edom with thy garments from Bashan?
Hi, Esau.
This that is glorious in his apparel, traveling in his greatness of his strength.
Esau.
I that speak in the righteousness mighty to save. Wherefore art thou red in thine apparel?
What's up, Esau?
It's a little Edomite. What's up, man? Come here, man. Oh, I didn't mean to offend you, man. I just wanted to grab.
Yeah, he was like
a little old Edomite. I had trodden the wine press alone, and of the people there was none with me, for I will tread them in my anger and trample them in my fury. And the blood shall be sprinkled upon my garments.
Oh, that's what you was just talking about.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
That's the spirit, because you said, I'm just going to keep on reading. Right. And that's what we was just talking about. Washing our feet in the blood of the wicked. We're going to have blood all over our garments.
That's right.
The Lord's going to be covered in blood. Mm-hmm. That says that in Revelation. He's going to tread the winepress.
That's bad.
Hey, we should get that, man. Tread the winepress. And you know where that's at? Revelation. It said the wrath of the Almighty. I love that scripture, man. You know where it's at? I can find it if you don't know where it's at. I read it all the time. I think it's a 19. But go ahead with that.
And I was, you read that with this.
It don't matter.
Okay. And I was, and I will strain all my raiment, for the day of vengeance is in my heart, and the year of my redeem is come. And I looked, and there was none to help, and I wondered that there was none to uphold. Therefore my own arm brought salvation unto me, and my fury it upheld me. And I will tread down the people in my anger, and make them drink in my fury. And I will drink down, bring down their strength to the earth. I gotta look for this one scripture.
Bring them down to the earth. Right now they riding high. They gonna be brought down low. Like that scripture said, they ain't gonna be drinking none of our wine in the kingdom. No, they get none. They got... Go ahead, read that.
Revelation 19:11. And I saw heaven open, and behold, a white horse. And he that sat upon it was called Faithful and True. And in righteousness he doth judge and make war. His eyes were as a flame of fire.
That's bad, man.
And on his head were many crowns. And he had a name written that no man knew but he himself. And he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood. And his name...
There goes again. It clothes in a vesture dipped in blood. That's from killing. Keep going.
And his name is called the Word of God. And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses, clothed in fine linen, white and clean. And out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, that with it he should smite the nation.
He shall love the nations? For God so loved the world, he shall love the nations. Read that again.
And out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, that with it he should smite the nations.
Smite means to kill, right? We should look that word smite up. Now go ahead, read that again.
And out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, that it should smite the nations. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron, and he treadeth the winepress of the fierceness of wrath of the Almighty. And he hath on his vesture and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And I saw an angel standing in the sun, and he cried with a loud voice, saying, and all the fowls that fly in the midst of heaven, come gather yourself together unto the shepherd, the supper of the great God, that ye may eat the flesh of kings, and the flesh of captains, and the flesh of mighty men, and the flesh of horses, and all of them that sit on them, and the flesh of all men, both free and bond, both small and great.
Right, because everybody's going to got it coming. The wicked, they come in all shapes and sizes. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of these poor people, we don't feel bad for them. They wicked as hell. They gonna die just like the rich man.
Yep, and the rich man gonna die just like the poor man.
Right, ain't no difference.
For real. Lord ain't gonna discriminate.
Nope.
Shit. Amos 1:9. Thus said the Lord, for three transgressions of Tyre, and for four I would not turn away the punishment thereof, because they delivered up the whole captivity to Edom, and remembered not their brotherly covenant.
Yeah, there go Esau again.
Yep. But I will send a fire on the wall of Tyre, which shall devour the palaces thereof,
Because really, yeah, the modern day Tyrus is like New York City. It has a giant port city back in the ancient world. But now, you know what I'm saying? Now the modern day Tyrus is really America. Go ahead.
Thus said the Lord, for three transgressions of Edom, and for four I would not turn away the punishment thereof, because he did pursue his brother with the sword, and did cast off all pity, and his anger did tear perpetually and kept his wrath forever. But I will send a fire upon Teman, which shall devour the palaces of Bozrah. Thus said the Lord, for three transgressions of the children of Ammon, and for four I will not turn away the punishment thereof, because they have ripped up the woman with child of Gilead, that they might enlarge their border. But I will kindle a fire in the wall of Rabbah, and it shall devour the palaces thereof with shouting in the day of battle.
And that's what Esau does today with his, with his colonialism. He just wants to enlarge his own border.
Right. His democracy.
Yeah, spread democracy and filth throughout the earth.
Right. I was just watching that earlier, man, that you mentioned that, how over in India, they was talking that democracy shit, man, how they trying to uphold democracy. I was seeing the midst of a bunch of heathens on that television screen.
Yeah, the hell with your democracy.
And that word, what, has its roots in Greek and Latin?
Well, it was an ancient, well, it means, democracy means rule of the people. Yeah, because remember the Peloponnesian Wars fought between the Athenians and the Spartans, and the Spartans beat the hell out of the Athenians to stop their because they started democracy. It was the Athenians. You know how in the movie 300, the Spartans said the Athenians were a bunch of boy lovers, a bunch of faggots, and philosophers, and the Spartans, they totally and utterly destroyed the Athenian Empire, because they was trying to spread democracy through the world. It's just like everybody always says, because people always think America is a democracy. They always say, we gotta uphold this democracy. But America was actually formed as a republic, which is not a democracy. But they turned it into a democracy, though. So go figure. That's why it's called Babylon. It's the land of confusion. Everything out here is all about confusion. You know what I'm saying? These people are confused. They walk around confused as hell. They don't know what's going on. You know, they don't know their ass from a hole in the ground. They don't know shit from apple butter. The difference between shit and peanut butter. They don't know. You can take some shit, throw some jelly on it, and give it to them. They'll eat it up and ask for another one. I mean, really, that's how they do it, bro.
County East Main to Bryce Road and Scarborough Boulevard.
We dealing with some dumbass people out here. And trying to teach them is like pissing against the wind. You ever piss against the wind before?
No.
Hell yeah.
Man, that shit flies right back on you.
You don't mean to do it.
Yeah.
You know, of course you don't mean to do that.
That's funny, what you just said, I'll agree with this.
It said pissing against the wind?
Oh, no. It's
oh, what does it say?
How then shall they call on him?
Oh yeah, you gotta teach it to them. I mean, you gotta teach it to them. Just because they're stupid don't mean we can't. Because you don't know who's gonna wake. You don't know who's gonna wake up. So somebody's gonna hear it and they're gonna wake the hell up. Because I used to be dumb as hell too. So some people argued I'm still dumb as hell.
Goes into that, it said, but I say, have they not heard then barely the sound of the world of earth and the words to the end of the world?
Oh, well, our words are going to the end of the world. We on the internet. That's an internet scripture right there. Because, I mean, you get on the internet, well, you get on YouTube and look at those demographics. The demographics, that goes back to that word democracy. Demo means people. But, people in almost every country have watched our videos. That's crazy when you think about
it. Yeah, Japan, like, Israel.
Japan. Not too many people in Japan, but they do get them. Well, I got my Japanese friend. He can't understand what we're saying, but, you know.
Translation.
Oh, yeah. She ain't an American woman.
What?
She'll have to walk with me every day. I ain't seen her from behind till now.
I had to get her on a diet or something.
Bro, don't make me put that on camera. It's like, no.
She won't, man. She won't.
Oh, nah, fuck it. You never know that. She could be a good woman, right?
Shoot her ass.
Fuck. Now tell your bitch that you ain't gonna celebrate Thanksgiving. See how long she's your bitch. See how long she stays with you then. Tell her you don't celebrate Christmas. See how long she sticks around. Oh, you ain't give me no Christmas present? Had the Hamite earrings.
Yeah.
It's just popular nowadays. Everybody got them Hamite earrings. Them big ass plugs in their ears. You gotta be out your mind to do that to your ears, man.
That's stupid shit.
Who the hell wants elongated earlobes? That's fucking weirdo shit. That's some heathen shit. That's a heathen for your ass. You got a big ass hole up in your earlobe. That's fucking weirdo shit, man.
There's some in their nose, man.
Hey, that's just fucking weirdo.
She laughing at
herself
like...
Man. Oh, you can't pay attention to these people. They're peasants.
Peons.
Yeah, they're peons.
This is,
They're minions.
This is, Ezekiel 21:9. Son of man, prophesy and say, thus saith Yahweh, say a sword is sharpened. And also firmest. It is sharpened to make a sword slaughter. It is firmest that it may glitter. Should we then make mirth? It contemneth the rod of my son as every tree.
Yeah, I mean, there you go. They're talking about that sword again. Why y'all keep talking about all this bloodshed and death? You're bringing me down. It's like, Hey, that's what this Bible's all about. The Bible's brutal, man.
Yeah, dude. It says, should we then make mirth? That's what this money motherfucker's trying to be all happy all the
time. Yeah, you're going to be all happy. Your happiness is going to be turned to sorrow. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. You know what I'm saying? That's what's going to go down. They're going to find out about that weeping and gnashing of teeth.
Yeah, that's right. That's sure.
You know, they're going to find out all about it, man.
Who way?
They say the children of the kingdom will be cast in the outer darkness, and there'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Mm-hmm. That's talking about our own people. They gonna get fucked up, and we gonna rejoice when they get fucked up. We gonna be the ones fucked through the power of the Lord. When the Lord gives us power, we gonna be fucking them up.
Yeah, that's a beautiful thing.
That's a very beautiful thing. That's why people they think you're crazy, because we applauded what happened in Paris. Like, that was beautiful. They're like, man, you're fucked up in the head.
Yeah.
Like, we're not fucked in the head. France is like, even though we know the government's behind it, but them people over there are foul, man. They're famous for being the most debaucherous, liberal, just fucking liberal, what do they call them? The left-wing liberal lunatics. That's the capital of liberal lunacy.
I can imagine what's going on over there.
It's just fucking freak show.
Right.
Non-stop freak show.
Like, imagine adultery.
Yeah, because what they call it, the city of love, don't they? Because anything goes over there. That's the most liberal country on the planet Earth. That's where half of fucking these liberals in America get their ideologies from.
I'm sick and this is 15 and 5.
That bitch is pretty.
For all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. Behold, saith the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world, the sword and famine, death and destruction.
Hey, that's what's coming, man. Death, destruction, plagues, famine.
For wickedness hath exceedingly polluted the whole earth.
The whole earth.
And their hurtful works are fulfilled. Therefore, saith the Lord, I will hold my tongue no more as touching their wickedness which they have profanely committed, neither will I suffer them in those things in which they have wickedly exercised themselves. Behold, the innocent and righteous blood crieth unto me, and the soul of the just complain continually.
That's what we do. We complain. People, why you complain so much? Because right. Really complaining is just a form of prayer. We just praying. Mm-hmm. We pray that the Lord kills these motherfuckers that profane his name.
That's right. And therefore, said the Lord, I will surely avenge them and receive unto me all the innocent blood from among them. Behold, my people is led as a flock to the slaughter. I will not suffer them now to dwell in the land of Egypt, but I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm and smite Egypt with plagues as before.
Right, as before, because America is spiritually Egypt. That's why there's a pyramid on the back of a dollar with the all sing Eye of Horus. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? There's a scripture in Revelation, the 11th chapter, that tells you it's spiritually known as Egypt.
And smite Egypt with plagues as before, and will destroy all the land thereof.
So this whole land is going to get laid waste, man. It's going to be laid low. It's going to be burnt the fuck up. There ain't going to be one stone left upon another.
Ain't going to be nada.
Nothing. It'll be desolate. Like, the word desolate means nothing. There's not a single one thing left.
Revelation 11 and 8.
Oh, there you go.
And their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city, which spiritually is called Sodom and Egypt.
Sodom and Egypt.
Where also our Lord was crucified.
Right, yep. Oh, because you know, the Lord was crucified in Jerusalem. That's spiritual too. Because you know, our people are likened unto Sodomites, right?
That's right.
And who's the ones responsible for the Lord being crucified?
Our people.
Because they're goddamn Sodomites. They're Egyptians. A lot of them even call themselves Egyptians.
That's right. Black Hawk.
They call themselves Sodnetter and what's some other names they give themselves?
Yeah.
All them goddamn African names. That's just some heathen sounding shit too.
Yeah.
Them Egyptian names just sound like a heathen name. It ain't got no kind of pizzazz to it, or no kind of funk or spirit to it. You know what I mean? It sounds heathenistic. It don't even sound good.
Black conscience is bullshit.
It sounds like some heathen shit.
Right. Egypt shall mourn, and the foundations of it shall be smitten with the plague and punishment that the Most High, Yahweh Shai, shall bring upon it. They that till the ground shall mourn, for their seeds shall fall through the blastings and hail, and with a fearful constellation, woe to the world and them that dwell therein.
Yeah, woe to all you heathens.
For the sword and their destruction draweth nigh.
Draw, man, it's near. And that's what we pray. Now look, we got a little sample of that destruction over there in Paris. But that ain't nothing. That's a drop in a bucket.
And for the sword and their destruction draweth nigh, and one people shall stand up to fight against another, and swords in their hands. For there shall be sedition among men, and invading one another. They shall not regard their king nor their princes, and the course of their actions shall stand in their power.
Yeah, just look at the Middle East, man. You see that right there. Almost all nations are converging over there.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody invading everybody. How many damn countries you got fighting over in Syria?
Oh shit, everybody's over there, man. Hell, I haven't heard a rumor. I read it that, I'm sure, was it Cuba?
Or Russia? Cuba?
Was it Cuba or...
Cuba getting it in?
Cuba or somebody's over there.
Yeah, all kind of motherfuckers is over there.
I can't remember.
France, Russia, man. America.
I gotta go back.
They say Cuba.
Yeah, somebody. It's one of them Latin tribes.
Oh, I believe you. What, Venezuela? I don't know. I got to look into that.
Yeah.
We need to look into that. Yeah, because I don't know. I believe it, though, man. They probably got some kind of interest over there.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Has to. If they're there, they have some interest over there. A man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able, for because... of their pride, the cities shall be troubled,
You can't get into France now. They closed the borders.
Yeah, they sure. They locked them down. Sure did.
About goddamn time they shut that shit down.
What's up, man?
Yo, that's your question. About the destruction that's coming to America. He said what? I don't know about the destruction that's coming to America.
Right there? Yeah, America. America, we're talking about East Coast to the West Coast. From up north to down south. All of it.
It's going down in flames.
All of it. That's why we out here. We're trying to warn. We're blowing that trumpet.
Yep.
Before war, you hear what? You hear that?
You hear that trumpet?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, hell no. Ancient times, boy.
Yeah. Y'all, hey, let me ask y'all a question. Y'all see what happened over there in Paris? Y'all know anything about that? You see that? Who do you think was behind that? Huh? Who do you think was behind those attacks in Paris?
That was something governmental shit.
Oh, you're right about that. There you go. You didn't fail the test.
There you go, Angus.
They say it's ISIS.
Well, I mean, they used
behind ISIS.
But there was Muslims. The government funds them. The United States, they on record giving ISIS weapons. They had congressional hearings on it. And asking them, why the hell are we giving ISIS weapons? So, it's in the records that they funded them.
How much some Jordans cost?
Like one, almost 200.
Damn!
I got a scripture though. This is Zephaniah 2:1. Gather yourselves together, yea, gather together, O nation not desired. Before the decree bring forth, before the day pass of the chaff, before the fierce anger of Yahweh come upon you, before the day of Yahweh's anger come upon you. Seek ye Yahweh, all ye meek of the earth, which have brought his judgment.
He's blowing that trumpet right now with that scripture.
He said, Yahweh, that's the name of the Most High.
Seek righteousness, seek meekness.
See
everybody
out there? They're doing
that on
purpose.
Yeah, I said, yeah.
It may be he shall be hid in the day of Yahweh's anger.
That's how the Lord gonna turn his back on them.
Hey, get that scripture. Hey, get it. Because that's the so-called Jews, the devil. Who do you think controls the United States and the whole world? It's the so-called Jews. They're not. We're the real Jews. They're not real Jews. You know, Jesus was the so-called black man, right? He had dark skin. But look, the so-called Jews, they control the planet Earth. They control Hollywood. They control the music industry. They print the money that's in your pocket, that's printed by the Federal Reserve, owned by Jews. You name it, the Jews is running it.
Proverbs 1:26, I will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh. When your fear cometh as a desolation and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind, when distress and anguish cometh upon you, then shall they call upon me, but I would not answer.
Yeah, because right now people, they don't care about the Lord or the ways of the Lord. But when that destruction comes here, and there's riots in the street, cannibalism, just killing, then all of a sudden they're going to be calling and praying to the Lord. But then it's going to be too late. Then the Lord's going to laugh at you.
That's right.
And just jack you up.
Then shall they call upon me, but I would not answer. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me.
The Lord will not be found on that day.
For that they hated knowledge and did not choose the fear of the Lord. They were none of my counsel. They despised all my reproof. Therefore shall they eat of their fruit of their own way and be filled with their own devices.
Yep.
I have a question too.
What's up?
You're here to answer.
Like this right here, don't you think this is like coming
what is
compared
it?
To the lower Jewish people that don't know what the other ones is doing now?
Well, yeah, of course, they like anybody else. Most of them was raised through ignorance. But they're higher ups, the rabbis, they know what they're doing. Like right there, they have something called the circumcision ritual. It's with the so-called Jews, when they have a baby boy, they circumcise the penis, and then they have a rabbi come out and suck the blood out of the baby's penis with his mouth.
He actually give the baby a blowjob.
Yep, it's right there. We got pictures of it.
That's part of their shit.
That's what they do. They worship Satan. And they're the ones that control this whole country. They control the world.
A picture speaks a thousand words.
Yep.
You know, I mean, there's a picture right there.
They got, you can get on YouTube, type in Rabbi Sucks Baby Penis, and they got rabbis breaking it down, explaining why you have to suck it out with your mouth.
Right.
And you cannot use tubes or vacuum. You got to suck it out
with your mouth.
You
got to use saliva.
Saliva.
And the funny thing is, the weird thing is, these babies is catching venereal infections from these rabbis, man.
It got so bad. New York had to pass a law to put a stop to the ritual. Because, yeah, like he said, babies, it was in the news, babies catching herpes and AIDS.
Dying from it, man.
Yep.
I'm going to go Revelation 2.
Oh, yeah, check this out.
Revelation 2 and 9. I know thy works, and tribulation, and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan.
So who's that talking about? Who's those who say they are Jews but are actually not, but they are the synagogue of Satan? That's those devils right there. The same one, you ever go through Bexley? You see them synagogues? You see them Jews? That's the synagogue of Satan. That's not the temple of the Lord. The Lord ain't nowhere near there.
Isn't there another school or temple, university on College Avenue?
Yeah, down by it, on the east side?
Yeah, right there.
Going out towards Canal Winchester. I know College Avenue. That's right. You're going down Livingston.
Right.
You take a right. That's College Ave.
Yeah, that's it. And it's a Jewish.
Yeah. It's right a Jewish there. Something. Yeah. Yeah. Well, that's Bexley right there.
Mm-hmm. That's part of it. Yeah.
Yeah. Because the so-called Jews, they don't send their children to the public school system. Did you know any Jews when you went to school? Hell no.
My friend, I'm Jewish.
Anyways.
That's why he got your back turned.
That's why he got his back turned.
You're a Jew on your mom's side or dad's side?
I got a scripture for you real quick.
Well, according to the Jew, say they got everything all messed up. They say that you are who your mother is. And that goes, because they teach nothing but lies. Because the Bible says you are who your father is.
Numbers 1:18.
Well, I'm just saying, according to the Bible, your nationality is determined by who your father is. The mother doesn't matter.
Numbers 1:18. And they assembled all the congregation together on the first day in the second month. And they declared their pedigrees. I said that word.
Pedigree.
Pedigrees after their families by the houses of their fathers.
By the houses of their fathers. That's why when you read all the genealogies in the Bible, it always says Abraham begot Isaac. You know, Isaac begot Jacob. It didn't say nothing about the women.
Abraham begot Michelle.
Yeah.
And Michelle begot Deborah.
Yeah. it didn't say that. You know what I'm saying? It's all about the man and the man's seed.
When you get married, you take on the woman's name. I'm sure y'all too young to probably get married, but you get married, you don't take on the woman's name, do you?
The woman takes the man's name.
That's right.
You know what I mean?
It's carrying on his heritage, Islam.
Yup. What's that?
In today's, it's hard to say.
Well, you know, you see a lot
when
of
there's barely a father there. So
well, exactly. That's all by design.
Right.
That's all by design too.
Yeah,
they don't want you to father in the house no more. Just the elite, they want to totally do away with families. They want to do away with genders, nationalities, everything.
That's right. They want chaos.
Chaos and confusion.
Yeah.
And that's why America is known as Babylon the Great. The Babylon is a Hebrew word that means confusion. And the Bible refers to America as being Babylon the Great.
Babel.
This is the Tower of Babel.
Okay.
That's all you hear is nothing but babbling and nonsense out here. Foolishness. Nothing but foolishness flourishes out here.
I don't care about no camera.
Oh, hold on, bro. Let me read this real quick. This is Genesis 11 and 5. And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower which the children of men built. And the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they have one language. And this they began to do, and now nothing will be restrained from them.
And when you read up above that, it said they let us go make a name for ourselves. Yeah, where's that part?
Start at one. Let me
okay,
start
read
top.
That.
11 and 1, Genesis yeah, 11 and 1.
And the original language was?
The original language is Hebrew. Well, what we call today is being Hebrew. It was what we call the Holy Tongue. That's the original language. That's the language of angels. Yeah, the Holy Tongue. Yeah, Lashon Kodash. It is now commonly known as Hebrew. Not Yiddish, Hebrew.
Shittish.
Yeah, Shittish.
And the whole earth was of one language and of one speech. And it came to pass as they journeyed from the east that they found a plain in the land of Shinar, and they dwelt there. And they said one to another, go to, let us make a brick and burn them thoroughly. And they had brick for stone, and slime had they made for mortar. And they said, go to, let us build us a city and a tower whose top may reach unto heaven, and let us make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad the face of the whole earth.
Yeah, because that's all America's all about. Everybody want to make a name for themselves. I'm the biggest, baddest motherfucker. All these rappers, what do they talk about? Yeah. About how great they are and how they the best this, they greatest at this. Everybody thinks they the shit when they really is really, they are the shit. They're shit. They're a pile of shit. Everybody thinks they're so fly, they ain't shit.
Ain't shit. And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower which the children of men built. And the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they have all one language, and this they begin to do, and now nothing will restrain from them, which they have imagined to do.
And that's the same spirit they got in America.
Same shit.
You know what I mean?
Trannies.
Tranny. You can do whatever you want out here. You got transsexuals. Now they saying Caitlyn Jenner is a American hero. A
beautiful woman.
Caitlyn Jenner won Woman of the Year award.
Sure did. That it did.
If you question that
thing. That thing.